give you a quick rundown of this Mexican and this Argentinian women's side. For Mexico, we have in goal Gabriela Herrera. We have Analeia Rodriguez, Lisbeth Angelis, who you can also read about on our website. If you do visit there, we've got a great article about Lisbeth. We've got Maria Gutierrez, Astrid Enriquez, Yamile Franco, and Marianne Lara. If we come across to the Argentinian team, who are in an incredible voice on the bus in this morning, playing a lot of Argentinian music, up and down, dancing up and down the aisles. We've got Jimena Arriveo, Camila Beltran, Daniela Bianco, Carolina Lagerato, Rita Riveros, and Aileen Roja. I'm also joined by a co-commentator for this game. Hello, Jasper.
Hello, good morning.
Welcome. Nice to see you, nice to see you. I haven't had a chance to organise a lot of co-commentators for these games, but I've instructed people to just show up. We've got 24 games today, running from 11 o'clock all the way through to 6:40. That's on Dutch time. So we will be covering games throughout the day, and hopefully I'll be joined by an array of co-commentators as well. Mexico in green and dark green, whereas Argentina playing in an unusual kit of dark blue, black and gold.
Happy to see some brave spectators in the stands.
Yeah, it's great to see the Mexican men's sides out there, isn't it? I mean, this is a matchup between two teams that I do believe could compete for the final in the women's competition. I kind of do expect Mexico to be in that final too. Strong by the Argentinian 10. A bit of space. But the number 12 on there for Mexico, that's Rodriguez. Keep your eye on Rodriguez, the number 12. Also keep your eyes on number 9 for Mexico when she's on the field. Lisbeth Angelis. Well, that's a great save, though, to start us off by the Argentinian number one. It's Roja in goal for the Argentines. Conditions not really improving at any point over this week, have they?
No. I hope this will be the last day of rain. The tournament, they say, the organization told me that tomorrow and especially Saturday will be a lot better. So
that's nice to hear, because of course on Saturday every single team will compete for a trophy of some description. We have of course the World Cups will be contested between the men's and women's side, especially the most elite. But we'll also see lots of plate competitions competing as well. We've got a bit of space now for the Argentines, and that should be a penalty to Argentina, as all three Mexican players, it's a free kick, sorry, from the halfway line, as all three Mexican players have run into their own half. So that's an indirect free kick to Argentina. Also, we've got Bianco, number 10, on closest to the side of the pitch there. A nice ball over by Bianco to Jimena.
Both teams do have a lot of control on the ball.
Yeah, I mean, Argentina haven't had the better results. I think Mexico's results have been a lot stronger in the tournament. But Argentina are a great side. So really, if I was to favour anybody with Mexico here, that's a great start as well. You can see how controlled that was. Mexican number 9, Lisbeth Angelis. One to watch, of course, in this game, slotting that ball home past the keeper, Roja. Yeah, the atmosphere on the bus this morning was absolutely ridiculous. I was on the bus with Costa Rica and Argentina, and they were absolutely bouncing. I spent some time in Argentina myself, and it was nice to relive some of their more classic pop songs as well.
Wonderful.
Another great strike by the Mexicans. Not enough pressure, really, from the Argentinian defence. So we've seen Mexico really split them open twice now. The number 8, Yamil Franco. So the goal scorers currently for Mexico, we've got Lisbeth Angelis, number 9, and Yamil Franco, number 8. Rodriguez. Franco. Angelis. Nice by the Argentines, though, to manage to tackle that ball out of possession. We've got a very damp Scot in the background there, I've noticed. Scotland's women's team, of course, been pretty strong in this tournament. Nice to watch Scotland's girls play. Also, the Welsh women's team as well, for anybody from the home nations listening. The Welsh women's team have been pretty good too. That Danish flag getting wetter, damper and more dreary in that corner of the stand. I think it's been there overnight, bless it.
It's taller reek, I think.
Yeah, I know, it's not really moved, has it? Yeah. At one point they had it direct in my camera line, and I was constantly calling any team in red Denmark. It's like an endless Freudian slip. I mean, I confused Denmark for Peru at one point. It should be kind of impossible. Luis Franco. Stopped by the Argentine number 10, Daniela Bianco there. For number 19, substituted on for the Argentine team. It's another good strike, a bit too much space there for the Mexicans. Angelis. Keep your eye, of course, on that air. That's a bit of a rash challenge there, wouldn't you say? Free kick, of course, to Mexico in that corner. The conditions aren't going to make fluid football easy today, though.
No, no. You see when they run on the pitch, you see the water coming up. Slidings as well will be rather difficult to control.
It'd also be nice to take this opportunity just to express our sympathies from the Homeless World Cup, because, of course, there's been a big 8-point something on the Richter scale earthquake in Chile this morning, and that has affected. It's only killed 5 so far that we know of, but there is tsunami warnings, of course, across the entire area, and that has affected the area where the Homeless World Cup was held in Santiago last year. So our thoughts are with anybody that's been affected by that. Angelis, cheeky flick over.
Oh,
that's really split Eileen Roja. It's a nice attempt by the Mexicans. So 5 minutes in, 3-0 to Mexico. Commanding really throughout the game. Argentina not with really any chances, but this game quite early on in the day, and it's not been played at much real pace, I think. Quite a cautious affair.
Mm-hmm.
So cross ball again. Another great shot by the Mexican side. And again, all across the face of the goal. Excellent tactics by the Mexicans. So my current tips for the women's tournament, of course, would be Mexico. Argentina, I could imagine finishing in the final, though they've not been the strongest team. Mm-hmm. The Chilean team, actually pretty reasonable as well in the women's competition. But what I think will happen is the Mexicans will reach the final against one of any number of other teams. That's another great strike on the Mexicans. Even maybe you could possibly imagine Scotland getting there as well. That's potentially possible.
Mm-hmm.
But I really don't think anybody's challenging Mexico for me in this women's tournament.
Yeah, you've probably seen a lot of matches, so I think you're the expert here. You can give some advice to the spectators.
Yeah, I have seen what I can only describe as a horrendous number of matches at this point now. I covered 14 yesterday. Even on the short day on Tuesday, I covered 10. Today, of course, we've got 24 games on pitch one. I doubt I'll cover all 24 for you, but I would imagine it's upwards of 15 today. Of course, the stream will be live throughout the day. Another excellent effort by the Argentines, just on the stroke of halftime, by the Mexicans, forgive me. But also, we've got 24 games, but we won't be commentating upon all of them. We will be covering them all with at least a single camera shot. So do stick around, because we're going to get all this action from pitch one covered at least.
Half-time on pitch one.
That's half-time. Commanding lead for the Mexicans.
Mexico in the lead, 5-0.
Yeah, they both played a technical game.
Both teams change
sides. It's a beautiful match to watch.
Yeah, some very nice clean goals, isn't there, by Mexico?
Mm. It is.
What I will do, though, for you is I'll take a look at this second stage. Because, of course, we have a first stage, a second stage, and a trophy stage. We get many trophies awarded. But let's take a quick look at this group. So Group B is Mexico, Argentina, India, and Scotland.
5-2 for South Africa.
Mexico leading that group with 3 points. Argentina second with 3 points. India with nothing, and Scotland with nothing. So you could say here that a Mexican win is quite good for Scotland, because the Argentines probably aren't going to win this group, but Scotland could still qualify if they come second in this group. So it's good for Scotland to get a win later on today. And also, Scotland have got Mexico later on, pitch one at 3 o'clock. That's a very tough ask for them. And then they're also playing India in our last game at 6:40. So it's a big day for Scotland. We could find out if Scotland do qualify for that final trophy stage today. But I suppose this is the result that Scotland are looking for. Of course, really worth mentioning that India have been pretty good throughout the tournament as well. So it's not to say that India won't, of course, qualify from this group, but I would expect Mexico to dominate. Sodden out there, isn't it? Absolutely sodden.
Respect for all these girls playing all day long. think. Yeah, we're talking in a row.
Three games a day at least. Points now, I believe. Mm-hmm. Two or three games a day. Some of the men's teams, I think Ireland played three games yesterday for the men. Ireland, of course, improving all the time. Had some really good results and a few unfortunate ones. Ireland probably the stronger of all the men's teams coming from the home nations, or the British Isles, of course. Wouldn't like to include the Republic in the home nations.
I haven't seen the fault here, but the goalkeeper might have came
nice
out
to see the Argentines get a chance, but that's a good save, though, again, by the Mexican goalkeeper, Gabriela Herrera. Of course, any Mexicans watching will know that I was taught that pronunciation by our usual Mexican co-commentator, Mariana, yesterday. I feel like my Spanish pronunciation is not too bad. Just drop the H's rolling out, I can do this. But when your name is Herrera, it's a little bit tough, but I managed to get myself there. Some very soggy Mexicans there in Panchos, which I suppose is their natural habitat. Chained away from the stands. Good hold, though, by Roger. Strike by Angeles. So Mexico making a little bit less use of the substitutions in this game. And we've got four substitutions possible, of course. It's four players on the pitch at any one time. We can operate rolling subs. And many teams, though, choosing not to. 11, Rita there for the Argentines. Rita Rivieros. A strong tackle by Rivieros. Screams of Rapido, Rapido, Rapido. But I think it's been quite a calm game actually, so I suppose a bit more Rapido might really help. A bit of Vamos in these two sides.
Especially from Argentina.
Yeah, I mean, they've not been terrible when they've had the ball at their feet, they've just not really controlled the position. It's just the ball retention of Mexico that's so strong in this turn.
Yeah.
It's interesting as well because lots of these women's teams are very comparable to the men's teams. I wouldn't really say that there's a big difference in standard as such. Might be a slight difference in pace possibly, but it depends. I mean, some of these women's teams have been so strong, competent and clever with the ball at the feet. Ball into space by the Argentines, but not really to anyone.
I think the Mexicans beautifully did the ball, let the ball do the work, while other teams try to run with the ball.
It's a bit of a rash challenge there, of course, by the number 7 for Argentina. Sliding in, and of course there's a bit of a disparity in size and strength between those two players. So you can really see how Jimena has sort of crucified the defender there. I think she'll be okay though, dead leg at last. Yeah, very much of the attitude that people can even just get up and survive.
But a slightly beautiful turn.
A lovely turn, wasn't it? We've got a slightly updated schedule coming in, so some of those games may change. I can only pray that has been updated also on the website for any of you guys that are following at home. We've got a slightly updated schedule here on pitch one. We will now be showing South Korea and a few games like that. But we'll also just tell you as we go along what games are what. It was a lovely turn.
It was a lovely turn.
It's nice to see that again. That's the Mexican number 10 there. An excellent piece of play to give them so a lot of possession and power. We've got Camila number 14 on for the Argentines. That's Camila Beltran. So, actually, strong second half by the Argentines because Mexico have been unable to score. Very impressive considering how strong Mexico are.
Yeah.
Nice bit of space though.
Oh.
There we go. So that's finally the deadlock's broken in the second half. Mexican number 6 slotting that ball into the back of the net. That's Astrid Enriquez for Mexico. Good strike by Enriquez to nutmeg the goalkeeper, Roger.
Costa Rica versus Scotland. Next match on pitch 2, Costa Rica versus Scotland. Both teams please go to the pitch.
So it's the last
on
few
pitch
seconds.
One. We're in the tournament, Mexico, Argentina, India.
Mexicans, which will really push them towards the top end of the competition. I do really expect to see Mexico at least competing in the final match. They'll definitely be in the final four.
Next match on pitch one.
How they played today, this game was really convincing. A little bit of much energy. They did the ball to work.
Nice save on the whistle by Roger in the Argentinian goal. Nice to see this again.
End of the game on pitch one.
That could actually, for me, that could be a goal.
Yeah.
We need a Russian linesman to dictate whether or not that's been a goal. Anybody watching is familiar with England as well, Cup victory in 1966, would they have? One of them, well, Cup victory, if not, in the FIFA World Cup, as opposed to the Homeless World Cup, which they haven't actually won. But Scotland have won twice, so if you are a Scottish person listening, do enjoy those statistics.